Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about one of the television standard that is defined by European system, that is nothing but PAL. In this video we are going to talk about the block diagram of PAL encoder. So let's begin with the topic. In the world, two main frequencies are used, and these are nothing but 50 Hz and 60 Hz. The 60 Hz frequency uses 30 scan lines per second, whereas 50 Hz uses 25 lines per scan. So, depending upon the frequency used, there are definitely two different standards of television comes into picture. One which operates on the frequency of 60 Hz and other which operates on the frequency of 25 Hz. That means it uses 25 lines per scan. Now, depending upon which frequency the system uses, there are different standard comes into picture. The first standard, the basic three standards are, the first standard is NTSC, which is defined by America. The second standard is PAL, which is defined by Europe. And the third standard is SCCAM, which is defined by France. Now, in this video, we are specifically going to talk about the PAL standard. That means the transmitter, that is encoder of PAL system. Now, the PAL system basically stands for phase alteration line. In case of NTSC system, the NTSC system is very much suitable and it provides a proper video quality in case of closed circuit environment. But it provides a change in the color of picture when it is used in the broadcasting environment. So to overcome this problem, European countries define the new standard, which is called as PAL standard. So we can say the PAL is nothing but the next extension or modification of the NTSC system. But it operates on the frequency of 50 Hz. In case of PAL system, there is a phase difference is get introduced between each alternate line, therefore which it is possible to stabilize the view. That means it is possible to stable the picture of the color. Now in case of PAL system, it provides many advantages. That means it uses more number of lines for scanning purpose. And because of which it is possible to capture a minute detail of the picture in detail. Second thing about the PAL system is nothing but it provides stable U. U is nothing but the color saturation, or we can say U is nothing but the predominant color received by the light. For example, we can say a green leaf having green hue, a red tomato having red hue. So depending upon the wavelength of the color, the U value is get changes. And therefore, you are used to differentiating between the different colors. Now, the other advantages provided by the PAL system is nothing but it provides easy studio mixing, it provides high gamma ratio, and its value having is approximately equals to 2:8. But at the same time, the system uses high frame rate, and therefore, it provides low signal to noise ratio. So apart from these disadvantages, because of the various advantages provided by PAL system, it is also used as one of the important standard in television system. Now let's look at the block diagram of PAL encoder, that is nothing but the PAL receiver system. So here, figure shows the basic block diagram of PAL encoder. Now let's go through it. It consists of various blocks. For example, it consists of matrix for generating the luminance and the various weighted signal. We will see the description in detail afterwards. Then it consists of low pass filters for providing restrictions on the frequency. Then there will be a delay liner for introducing a delay. Then adder is used for adding all the signals together before applying it to the balance modulator. Two different balance modulator are used depending upon the various input signals. Then again, it uses burst gate, pulse shapers and delay circuit. Then frequency dividing counter circuit and blanking and synchronization pulse circuit. It also uses multivibrator for providing a square wave as the input signal. So this is what basically the block diagram of PAL encoder. Now let's discuss the block diagram in detail. Now here, the gamma corrected RGB signals are matrix to form Y signal and weighted color difference signal. So now moving back to the block diagram, here RGB are the gamma corrected signal and they are applied as an input to the color matrix. A suitable color matrix is selected so that we can get a Y signal, that is nothing but the luminance signal, and the different weighted signal. The different weighted signal are nothing but the difference between the RGB color and the luminance signal. So here we are using basically two different signals which are weighted, and these are B minus Y and R minus Y. Now these signals, before applying it to the adder or before applying it to the balance modulator, they are get frequency restricted by using a low pass filter, so that only a low frequency is get passed through the circuit and all the higher frequencies which are above cutoff frequency are get blocked by the filter. So the low pass filter having frequency of about 1.3 megahertz, and therefore the frequencies which are above 1.3 megahertz are get blocked by the filter. Now the next is the weighted color difference signal from the filters are then applied to the corresponding balance modulator. In case of NTSC encoder, we know that there are two types of signal which are called as I and Q or U and V. But in case of PAL system, the signals are specifically U and V. Therefore, as there are two signals, therefore two balance modulators are used. One is for U signal and one is for V signal. One switching cycle takes two lines. The square wave switching signals from the multivibrator applied to the half wave frequency, that is approximately 7.8 kHz. Now in the block diagram, there is a block of multivibrator which is basically used for providing the switching signal to the circuit, and it having a frequency of 7.8 kHz. Now the double-sided suppressed carrier signal from the modulator are get added, and it results into the quadrature amplitude modulation that is called as QAM. And chrominance signal C, here this passes through the filter which remove harmonics of the subcarrier frequency and restrict the upper and lower standards of the approximated value. Now let's move back to the circuit diagram or block diagram again. So now here 7.8 kHz multivibrator is present, which is used for performing the switching operation. And now after balance modulator, a bandpass filter is present, which is basically used for providing a frequency restricted frequency or the frequency restriction on the signal. Now further, the outputs are given to the adder circuit, where it is get combined with the luminance signal and sync signal to form a composite video signal. Now the composite video signal is nothing but the video signal which consists of color information of the image, then it consists of blanking pulses for making the retrace invisible, and it also consists of horizontal and vertical synchronization pulses. The horizontal and vertical synchronization pulses are basically required to have a coordination or to have a synchronization between transmitter and receiver scanning. Now in case of horizontal and vertical synchronization pulses, amplitude of both the pulses is remains same, but their phase is different, so that it is easy for the receiver, or so that it is possible for the receiver to distinguish between them or to separate out them during the scanning purpose. Now the horizontal syncing pulses are get added at the end of the each cycle, whereas or at the end of the each line, whereas vertical sync pulses are get added at the end of each field. So all these pulses along with the blanking pulse which makes the retrace visible and the actual color information is get present in the composite video signal. The burst signals are obtained from the circuit that feeds the color subcarrier to the modulator circuit. Each burst gate is controlled by delayed pulse at FH rate obtained from the frequency divider circuit. So basically here the color burst circuits are used to provide the color burst signal, and that circuit which provides the color burst signals are called as burst gate circuit, and it is synchronized with the delay pulse having frequency of FH. Now the colorplexed composite video signal is given to the main transmitter so that it can get transmitted to the receiver by using a suitable channel. The sound signal after being frequency modulated, we know that in case of television, two types of modulation takes place. One is the frequency modulation, another is the amplitude modulation. Amplitude modulation is specifically related to the modulation of the video signal so that we can transmit the video information easily, whereas frequency modulation is specifically for the audio signal. We cannot use the same modulation technique, that is amplitude modulation, for the audio signal, because in case of interference with the noise signal, the noise basically affects the amplitude of the signal, and therefore if the amplitude contains some audio information, then after interruption the signal may get corrupted. So to avoid that, the frequency modulation is used for the audio signal. because in case of frequency modulation, the information is stored in the form of frequency variation, and noise do not have any effect on the frequency. It basically having effect of amplitude. So even if the amplitude of the signal is get changed, the actual information which is in the form of frequency variation is remain same. And for that matter, the frequency modulation is used for production of, or it is used for audio signal or voice signal. So after obtaining the colorplexed composite video signal, the noise signal, or we can say the audio signal, is get added with it after frequency modulation purpose. Finally, it is the signal is get radiated by using the antenna system. So in this way, the signal from audio device and the signal from the video part are get combined. As only one transmitter antenna is used, we need to combine the circuit, or we need to combine the signal. So therefore, if we look at the normalized block diagram of the TV, then it consists of transmitter, receiver, and there will be a combining network. The function of combining network is to combine the amplitude modulated video signal and frequency modulated audio signal, and then pass it to the antenna by using a suitable channel. So now let's move back to the block diagram of PAL encoder and summarize this topic. So here the RGB, which is properly color corrected signals, are then given, first of all, given to the matrix so that it can produce a luminance signal, that is Y signal, along with the weighted signal. The weighted signal are nothing but the difference between the primary color and the luminance signal. So here we are using two types of weighted signal, and they are nothing but B minus Y and R minus Y. These signals are then frequency restricted by using a low pass filter having frequency response, or we can say having a center frequency of 1.3 MHz. Now here the signals are get delayed. So because of that, it is get delayed with respect to Y. Therefore, in order to compensate that delay, here in case of Y path, the delay liner circuit is used. So basic function of the delay liner circuit is to compensate the delay which occurs in weighted signal. Now further, the signal is given to the balance modulator through a adder circuit. The two different types of balance modulator are used. One is for U signal and one is for V signal. Now here the multivibrator is used for providing the switching pulses, and along with the multivibrator, blanking and sync pulses generator circuit is used, which provides horizontal and vertical blanking pulses. Now burst gate circuit and burst shaper and delay circuit is also used for providing the color burst signal to the modulator. Now here the frequency, or we can say the signals, are get phase shifted by plus minus 90 degree, and then it is given to the balance modulator. Further, the frequency shift of 0 degree is applied and the signal is given to the balance modulator, which is related to the U signal. Now the U signal is first of all passes through the band pass filter so that it can passes all the frequency band which comes under the frequency range of the band pass filter, and finally the signal is given to the adder. So at the output of the adder, we have a composite video signal which consists of actual color information, blanking pulses for making retrace invisible, and horizontal and vertical sync pulses so that we can have a synchronization between the transmitter and receiver scanning. Now in order to boost the amplitude of the signal, or in order to improve the strength of the signal, a video amplifier is used. And finally, in the circuit, the signal is given to the main transmitter, which is, we can say, it basically a combiner circuit, because here we can say that the input to the main transmitters are nothing but the video signal from video amplifier and sound signal from, which is a frequency modulated signal. So these two signals are get combined. So we can say it is a main transmitter circuit or combining block, which is used to provide a combined signal which consists of both audio as well as video of the image or picture. And finally, the transmitting antenna is used for transmission of the signal to the receiver, so through a proper given suitable channel. So this is what about the block diagram of PAL encoder, that is nothing but PAL transmitter. The main advantages provided by the PAL system is nothing but the large number of lines are used for the scanning purpose so that a minute details of the picture can be captured. Then it also provides the advantage of stable hue, that was the problem in NTSC system, which is get overcome in the PAL system. And also it provides a function of easy studio mixing. So these are the advantages provided by PAL encoder. Though its cost is very high, its signal and ratio is very less, and also it uses a high frame rate. So these are the disadvantages of the PAL system. Apart from these disadvantages, even the system is used in many of the European countries, which operates on the frequency of 50 Hz, and therefore the PAL system uses 25 lines per frame. So this is what about the block diagram and its working of PAL system. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.